Second and last question is this necessary to follow madhab? At times we are told to just follow Quran and Sunnah. Again, this is a strange kind of misunderstanding and confusion. To follow Quran and Sunnah. The question is, I will give you a very simple answer so that everybody may understand and appreciate it. Why all of you, our scholars, our learned people, the imams and the executives and the spokesperson, why you have come here tonight? To listen someone. Why you want to listen him? To learn. What you want to learn? Quran and Sunnah. Of course, the basic sources are Quran and Sunnah. But everybody can't understand everything from Quran and Sunnah. How many people amongst you are in a position to read the Arabic and understand Quran without any translation or without any help of tafsir or without help of any scholar? How many are you in a position to understand the Holy Prophet's thousands and thousands, hundreds of thousands of ahadith which are written in Arabic without help of any scholar? How many people in the whole Ummah can understand directly the text of Quran and Sunnah? Do they understand? No. So those who say that you should just follow Quran and Sunnah, you should not follow any madhab or any imam of fiqh, just follow Quran and Sunnah, what will happen practically? Let us put this whole hypothesis in a practice. You say that he wants, yes, okay, I want to follow Quran and Sunnah and not any imam and not any madhab. Now he will say, you will say, thousands and millions of Muslims say, but sorry, we can't understand Quran. We don't know Arabic. We don't know Hadith because we don't know Arabic. And even by knowing just language, everybody can't understand the Quranic meanings and Hadith applications. So what the alim, the person who told just follow Quran and Sunnah, what will he suggest to you then? When you will say that I want to follow Quran and Sunnah, but unfortunately I can't understand Quran and Sunnah. So how should I understand? How should I learn? So what would he say to you then? He will say, come to me, the imam of that particular mosque. The imam sahab will say, come to me, I will teach you Quran and Sunnah. So it means, when we go to Imam Abu Hanifa, he does not say, listen to me and don't listen to Quran and Sunnah. Imam Abu Hanifa, the Imam of Madhab al-Hanafi, has just taught us the Quran and Sunnah. Imam Malik has taught to his followers the legal meanings of Quran and Sunnah. Imam Shafi'i, Ahmad bin Hanbal, they have just taught the meanings, derived the meanings from Quran and Sunnah. Then they have compiled them with evidences and arguments. Then they have put them in a systematic way with principles, and they have elaborated them, make them in the form of articles, and then they have conveyed the same meanings of Quran and Sunnah which we were unable to understand directly. They have made them easily understandable. That Imam says, come to me, I will teach you Quran and Sunnah. It means that Imam wants that accept me your Imam and don't accept Abu Hanifa your Imam. If you are supposed to go to Imam of mosque to understand Quran and Sunnah, so what is the difference between the two? You are going in the same way to learn Quran and Sunnah's commandments from this Imam, and don't go to the Imam-e-Azam Abu Hanifa, who is Imam of all Imams. And don't go to Imam Shafi, who is Imam of the Ummah. So the Mazhab is nothing against Quran and Sunnah. This is a jurisprudential service rendered to the teachings of Quran and Sunnah. When you are ill, where do you go? Why don't you use the medical books? Go to a bookshop, buy a medical book on your own and find out the treatment and just treat yourself. Why do you go to a doctor? You know English and the books are written in English. Just go and read the books. Why medical colleges are opened? Why the specialists are there to teach them? Why there are 5, 7, 10 years, 8 years courses? And why there is up to MD specialization in medicine? Why? Everybody should be able to read the medical books on medicine. Everybody should be able to read the books on surgery. And he should start surgery, he should start operations. I say that, come on, give me a book on surgery, I will operate you. Would you accept me as a surgeon?
No.
You will say, we accept you for learning of Quran, Sunnah, Islam and all these things, but we are not ready to give our life to you for surgery, our heart to your surgery, because I am not a specialist on that. So you need a specialist for every discipline. If your car is broken, would you be happy to give to Sheikh Faisal Abdul Razak to fix my car? Because we read Juma behind him and we get all guidance from him. Would he be able to fix your car too? No, these are specialities. You will go to a mechanic. So the Imams and Mazhab are the mechanics of Islamic jurisprudence. They are the doctors of Islamic jurisprudence. They are the engineers. They are the specialists. For medicine you go to a doctor. For engineering you go to an engineer. For psychotherapy you go to a psychotherapist. You go to a psychological medicine specialist. You go to a computer. My computer is broken, it is down now. So should I start opening it and because I am Sheikh and this and that? So should I start fixing my own computer? No, nothing. Everything is, you accept specialization in everything. This is the question. You accept specialization in everything. And going to the specialists to understand that particular point, you accept this. Then comes the matter of deen. You say everybody and every Imam is the specialist. Don't go to Imam Abu Hanifa and Imam Shafi and Imam Malik and I want your number. So these people are just quacks. They are not specialists. Imam Aimma and Mazahib, for example, for hadith we go to Imam Bukhari. For tafsir we go to Imam Razi. For hadith we go to Hafiz ibn Kasir or ibn Khaldun. For philosophy we go to Ibn Sina. Don't we do? For every discipline of knowledge. For international law we go to Stark. For international law we go to Oppenheim. For your English jurisprudence we go to Salmond. For English law you go to Austin. For constitutional law you go to constitutionalist. For each and every discipline, may be religious, may be secular, social or scientific, you go to professors, you go to specialists. Then when the matter comes to Islamic jurisprudence, Islamic law, why shouldn't we go to the specialists? So the specialists on these particular subjects are known as Imams of Mazahib. Like specialist on hadith is Bukhari and Muslim and Abu Dawood and according to all other things, disciplines. That's why Holy Prophet ﷺ said, so the order establishing the schools of fiqh, the fiqh and the faqih and the imam of fiqh and mujtahid. This is again the commandment of Quran and commandment of hadith. Quran says that there should be a group amongst you. وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ تَعِفَةٌ لِيَتَفَقَّهُوا فِي الدِّينِ. There should be a group amongst you, a group of specialist people, those who should go and specialize in fiqh of deen. There should be a group of people. The Quran has excluded, rejected or refuted the idea that everybody who is the competent authority. It has been rejected. وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ تَعِفَةٌ. Not everybody amongst you is a competent specialist or authority on fiqh. Fiqh. No. There should be a group, a class, some people amongst you. لِيَتَفَقَّهُوا فِي الدِّينِ. They should go to specialize in fiqh الدِّين. In the religious and jurisprudential speciality, they should become specialists on Islamic jurisprudence and Quran and deen understanding. And then they come back after being specialist, they should teach other people. This is the Quran. They should teach other people. Another verse of Holy Quran. Quran says, لَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَىٰ أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِتُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ. If they have received any news, they shouldn't decide on their own, on that news. They don't know whether the transmitter or narrator or reporter is a reliable person or not, news is right or not, what is the meaning of the whole thing. They are needed to refer it to Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. His sunnah means sunnah. Wa ila ulil amri minhum, or to those people who are specialists in deen, who are specialized persons. And what is the definition of specialists? لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِتُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ. Specialists are those who can derive the basic things and understanding and wisdom from the verses and from the situation. Those who have derivative capacity, inductive capacity, those are specialists. And they, common people, are supposed to refer their matters to those specialists. And the third Quranic verse is, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. If you don't know anything and you want to learn, you should not learn on your own. You should go to the specialists, those who are Ahlul Dhikr, those who are competent on this Dhikr, on this Nasiya of Quran and Sunnah. So Quran is referring to you towards specialists. This is Quran. And in Hadith, Holy Prophet says in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, Muttafaq alayh, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. Whenever Almighty Allah intends and decides to bless someone with special favors and mercies, He makes him faqih in his deen. He makes him faqih, imam of fiqh in his deen. This is Allah's blessing. So fiqhuddin, to become specialist of fiqh, yufaqqihu fiddin, of fiqah. This is Allah's special mercy. Holy Prophet said, faqihun wahidun أَشَدُّ عَلَىٰ أَلْفِ عَابِدٍ أَشَدُّ عَلَىٰ الشَّيْطَانِ مِنْ أَلْفِ عَابِدٍ. One faqih, one jurist, is heavier on shaitan as compared to 1,000 worshippers. If there are 1,000 pious people, 1,000 pious people worshipping, and on the other hand there is one person who is specialist in fiqh, he is heavier and more sound and protected as compared to 1,000 worshippers. Because shaitan can any time attack on him and he can mislead them. But the one who has become the faqih, he is protected because of Allah's blessed knowledge. So that's why after the companions and their followers and successors, specialization came into existence. Some a'imma started compiling hadith and they started working on transmission of hadith, they became the transmitters, muhaddiseen. Some became traditionalists. Those who are specialists became specialists in verifying the truthfulness and soundness or reliability of the narrator. And some people started working on the meanings of Quran and meanings of hadith, those which were transmitted. Muhaddis is not a specialist of meaning. He is a specialist of transmitting. And faqih is a specialist on the meanings, on the implications. So at the same time, there were 10 fuqaha sahaba and thousands were muhaddiseen. Among the companions of Holy Prophet, there were 10 mujtahid sahaba. How many? Mujtahid. They are known as maruf bil ilm wal ijtihad. The mujtahid sahaba were only 10. And the transmitters, the radis, the reporters sahaba, there were hundreds of them. Every reporter and transmitter was not mujtahid and faqih. There were very few who were specialists on the meanings, on the law, on the legal and technical and jurisprudence. So Holy Prophet and companions and sahaba used to refer the people, go to that sahabi to understand the meaning, jurisprudential or juristic meaning of Islam or Quran and hadith. So in this way, when all these things were collected and combined, so those who became the compiler of hadith transmission, they became A'imma Bukhari, Muslim, Tirmizi, Muhaddiseen. Those who compiled the meanings and juristic implications of Quran and Hadith among those people, the same Muhaddiseen and Ulama, they became the A'imma of Fiqh. So they compiled the Fiqh. This was just an juristic interpretation of Quran and Hadith, and Mazhab is nothing else. So since a common person doesn't understand what was repealed and what was not, what was revealed first and what was the second commandment revealed later, so what was later on repealed, what was absolute and what was other commandment which qualified it, Muhaddis does not tell these things, Imam of Hadith. What was revealed as a general sense and what was another commandment which specified it, what was the commandment of Quran or Hadith which was just common, and then what was the commandment which created an exemption in it, what was absolute, which was the commandment which qualified it. So Muhaddiseen, they do not know these things. All these things were the specializations of A'imma of Fiqh. So those who compiled all these sciences and then compiled the juristic knowledge of Quran and Sunnah, they became the founders of the Mazahib of the Fiqh, and this was a great blessing of Almighty Allah on Holy Prophet's Ummah till today and up till the Day of Judgment, that whenever we want to know, you go to Hadith, you will never found a single chapter in Hadith that how many fara'id are of wudu, how many wajibat of salat, how many nawaqidat of salat, how many mustahabbat of salat, how many makruhat of salat. Hadith is never quoted and transmitted in this way. And you need to know the laws. Hadith carries the substance of the message, does not carry categorically in a legal, juristic way the things. This is like a constitution, a book of law. Everything is written in articulation. So these were the A'imma who articulated all these things and compiled and articulated with all evidences and made the practicing of the deen of Islam and the Sunnah of Holy Prophet easy for every Muslim. So that's why it has become compulsory for a common Muslim to follow each of any of these mazhabs, means Imam. And following the mazhab means following Quran and Sunnah with specific interpretations. Is it clear or not? Thank you.